Well, here we go.
I am very old, and I haven't been on a horse. Oh, God. Okay.
Welcome back here, sir.
Oh.
Yeah, fine.
Oh, he doesn't like me. Oh my God. Put my clothes on. Oh my God.
Finally, Fernando and I are ready. No heck. 5 hours of trekking up a steep path through the forest lie ahead. The trip up the mountain isn't an easy journey. The track's narrow and Fernando keeps walking a little too close to the edge for my comfort. The mountain I'm heading for, Kawa Kapo, is considered to be so special that many Tibetans come here on pilgrimage every year if they can. It's one of the most holy mountains in Tibet. As we continue up the track, I'm getting a real sense of anticipation, a sense that I'm very close to the end of my journey. That little dream I had all those years ago is about to become a reality. As I get closer and closer to Shangri-La, more and more prayer flags line the path. They're placed here by fellow pilgrims on their way to the mountain. It really makes it feel like a very special place. As we carry on through the forest, finally, I get a first glimpse of the valley below. But wouldn't you know it, after days of travel and nearly 50 years of wanting to get here, the clouds have settled across the valley and the mountain is out of view.
I am without words. Is this the sacred mountain?
This is the sacred mountain, and right now you're looking at the Kawa Kapo right here.
That in the cloud.
Where the glacier were in the cloud.
Will the cloud lift? Will I be able to see the whole thing? Although this is staggeringly beautiful and extraordinary, Anu says I have to have good karma and maybe the clouds will lift, because my image, as well as the valley, is of this cone-shaped mountain that will take my breath away. This is fantastic. The journey has been fantastic, but to see that would be marvellous, wonderful. It would make my day, probably make my life, I think.
We carry on to find a place to camp for the night, hoping that tomorrow will be clear and bright. Later that night, around a warming fire, I show Anu the Book of Lost Horizon by Hilton. The book that was inspired by the very mountain and valley that I'm now camped in. This book, Anu, you see, maybe put it in the light. It's called Lost Horizon. And I read it, this is the mountain. This is the snow mountain. And I read it a long time ago. And the story is of some people finding themselves lost in the valley and going to the monastery, which is just below this beautiful, beautiful mountain. For a long time, I thought it was just a book, a story. Didn't know that there was a real snow mountain. Didn't know it existed until very recently. And so I thought I would come and see if it would be my heaven on earth. Is that good?
Kojichi.
Kojichi.
Very good. Kojichi. Thank you for coming here. You found the place.
I think I have. I think I have.
In the Gonluchi Burian.
He's very happy that you made all the way to here from very far away.
I'm very happy too.
More big gauge so said.
It's early the next day. All I could think about through the night was, would the clouds lift in the morning? It's my last chance to see Shangri-La, the perfect snow-capped mountain of Kawakapo and its little valley. It's been a long journey for me travelling across China and Tibet, and a very long wait to finally see if my dream can ever come true. Oh, wow. Fantastic. I am without words, it's so beautiful. This is my Shangri-La. The little valley down there is just how I imagined it in the book, exactly like that. And then these great mountains surrounded it, which are very lush and fertile. The river running down and then going up and up to this beautiful, beautiful, unbelievable cone of snow which changes in the light as the sun hits it and then it disappears again in the clouds. Coming through the clouds, you can just see this wonderful, amazing light and the clouds shifting and this cone just rising up above. So hard to explain that I feel very calm inside, which is very unusual for me. I've also felt that I've achieved things that I never thought I would achieve at this stage of my life.
I've overcome certain fears and